Hi guys, today we're going to see how you can create a WhatsApp business account. So let's say you're running a business and you want to directly connect with your customers to promote your products and services. You can do that easily by creating a WhatsApp business account. WhatsApp business account lets you directly interact with your customers and to answer their questions throughout their purchase. So after watching this video, you will be able to create a WhatsApp business account like this, where you will be able to add details about your business like this. And you can also display your products like this. And when your customer opens your WhatsApp profile, they can view your products and they'll be able to add your products to their cart. And if they want to purchase the product, they can send you a message like this. Once your customer sends a message, you will receive a message like this, and you can directly connect with them and deliver your product. We will also see how you can send automatic messages to your customers after working us like this, and you can also send greeting messages to your new customers. Okay, I'm Brian from Website Learners, and let's create our WhatsApp business account. Now, to create a WhatsApp business account, we are going to do four steps. The first step is to install the WhatsApp business app. So to install the app, let's go to the Play Store on our mobile and search for WhatsApp business. And you will get this app. Now to install it, just click install. And the app will be installed. Now click open. So now we have successfully installed the WhatsApp business app. Once you have installed the app, we can go to step 2, which is to register our mobile number. So to register the mobile number, click agree and continue. Now here you need to select whether you want to use the same WhatsApp number which you're using or use a different number for your business account. We recommend you to use a different number so that it will be easy for you to manage your chats. Now here you need to enter your number. Once you've entered your number, click next. Now here, it will ask you to verify your phone number to create an account. So let's click OK. And now WhatsApp will automatically detect the OTP. Once you're done, click continue. Now click allow. Again click allow. And then click skip here. So now we have registered our mobile number. Once you've registered your number, we can go to step 3, which is to create your business profile. So to create the business profile, first, let's add a profile picture for your business. So let's click here and click gallery. Now just select the image and click done. And as you can see, the image has been added. Now here, enter your business name. I'm going to enter Cake Bites. And then select the category of your business. Just click here. And you will get different options. Select the category you want. I'm going to select this. Now if you want to add more details about your business, just click Show More Options. And you will get these options. Now here, you can enter a few lines about your business. And here, enter your business address. I'm going to add the address. Once you've entered all the details, click Next. And click Not Now. So now we have created our business profile. Once you've created your business profile,
Now, how will you let your contacts know about your business? Next, let's see how you can send a message to your contacts about your business. So to do that, just click here and you will find all the contacts saved on your mobile. Select the contact you want to send the message. I'm going to select this contact. Now here, enter some details about your business. And click send. As you can see, the message has been sent. Once you've sent the message, that person will receive a WhatsApp notification like this, and if they open it, you can see that they have got our message. Now if they click here, they can see our profile picture, our account type, some details about our business, our business address, and the category of our business. Okay, this is how you can send a message to your contacts and let them know about your business. Next, let's go to the final step, which is to add products to your WhatsApp profile. So to add your product, click here and click Business Tools. Now click Catalog and you will get this page. Now to add your product, click Add Item. Now first, let's add our product image. So let's click Add Images and then click Gallery. Now here, select the image you want. I'm going to select this and click OK. As you can see, the image has been added. Now in the same way, you can add multiple images of your product by clicking Add Images. Once you've added the images, now here, enter your product name. I'm going to enter Red Velvet Cream Cake 1/2 kg. Here enter the product price. And then enter a small description about your product. Okay, once you've entered all these details, click Save. As soon as you click Save, WhatsApp will take a minute to review your product. Once it's reviewed, you can see that the product has been added. In the same way, you can add the other products. And you can add up to 500 products to your WhatsApp business account. Okay. So this is how you can add products to your WhatsApp business account.
So now we have successfully created the WhatsApp business account and added products to it. Next, let's see how someone can view your products and purchase them using WhatsApp. So to purchase products, all they have to do is
just open the chat. And this is how our WhatsApp profile will look. Now if a customer clicks here, it will take them to this page where they can select the product they want to purchase. Now let's say a customer wants to buy this product and clicks Add to Cart. Now if they click View Cart, here they can select the number of items they want. So let's click here and select the number of items and click Done. Now if the customer wants to send a message along with the order, they can enter the message here. And if they click here, the order will be sent to you. This is how your customer can view your product and purchase them using WhatsApp. Okay, once the customer places the order, you will receive a message on WhatsApp like this. Now if you open it and click View Cart, you can see the details of the order. Once you get an order, you can chat with the customer to collect more details and process the order. Okay. Now let's say you're getting multiple orders like this and you want to organize your orders. How can you do that? So next, let's see how you can organize your orders by adding a label like this which will make it easier for you to manage your orders. So to add the labels, just click here, click Business Tools, then click Labels, and you will get different types of labels which you can add to your customer's chat. Now if you want to create your own label, just click here and create the label you want. Now to add labels, go to your chat and tap and hold the customer's chat to which you want to add the label. Now click here and select the label you want. I'm going to select this one and click Save. As you can see, the label has been added. Now in the same way, you can add labels to all your customers' chats. This is how you can add labels to your customer chat. Okay, next, let's add the working hours for your business. So to set the working hours, click here, click Business Tools, then click Business Profile, and it will take you to your business profile. Now here, click Business Hours, then click Schedule, and select your schedule type. I'm going to select this. Now here, you can set the working hours for each day. So let's click here and select the working hours. Once you're done, click Save. Now if your customer opens your WhatsApp profile and clicks here, you can see that we have now got the working hours. Okay, this is how you can set the working hours for your business. Now let's say you're offline and a customer sends a message after the working hours. How can you reply to your customer? You can do that by sending an automated message to your customers. So to do that, click here, then click Business Tools, and click Away Message. Now enable this option. Once you have enabled this option, we can now automatically reply to our customers. Now if you want to edit your message, just click here and enter the message you want. Okay, next, you need to set when you want to send this message. So to do that, just click here and you will get these options. As I want to send the messages after the working hours, I'm going to select this option. Now if you want to send this message to all your customers, click here and select everyone. Once you're done with all the changes, click Save. Let's see how it works. Now let's say a customer sends a message after the working hours. Here you can see that they have automatically received the message. This is how you can reply to your customers after your working hours. Okay. Now let's say a new customer sends a message to you and you want to send an automatic reply like this. How do we do that? Next, let's see how you can automatically send a welcome message to your new customers. So to do that, click here. Then click Business Tools and then click Greeting Message. Now here, enable this option and you will be able to send a welcome message to your customers. And here, you can edit the message you want to send to your customers. Once you're done, click Save. Okay, now let's say a new customer sends a message to your WhatsApp account. Here you can see that the welcome message has been sent automatically. Now you know how you can send a welcome message to your new customer.
Okay, so that's it guys. Now you know how you can create a WhatsApp business account. Now if you want to connect your website with your WhatsApp account, you can watch this video. And if you don't have a website, you can easily create one by watching this video. Also make sure you subscribe to Website Learners for more videos like this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.